So the presentation about the partnership structure, and some general information about partnership, what is it, why it's needed, what is the some common mistakes. It's a special part. I wanted to just tell you what maybe to avoid or try to think about it before you're doing partnerships or in any form, doesn't matter which form. So why partnerships? So partnerships, it's just a general term. It's when several people or companies, they join together to do something, to do some business, or they buy in some assets, or they put several assets together and trying to make some profit and then share this profit. So it's historical, I think it's very old structures, and but it's still the structure's still developing, and the latest development, I think it was about 10-15 years ago, is limited liability partnerships. It wasn't exist before, in existence before, so it's still developing. So yes, I explained why partnerships exist. Who participate in the it could be, you could be a self-employed, you could be the owner of the company, you could be the resident or non-resident, doesn't matter, and so still you can participate in all kind of partnerships. The next question, important question, what is the taxation and what is the kind of specific of each type of partnerships? So we have three main types of partnerships. It's like it's saying usually general partnerships, historically it's usually two or several people joining together to do some business, and they agreed between each other, so they okay, they're doing this and they share this profit from this venture. Later it's becoming limited partnership. For limited partnerships, you already need it to be registered. The general partnership, you don't need to register in company's house. So you can have a verbal or written agreement between you, and the only thing you need to register it in with HMRC. And how it's working in a partnership in terms of taxation, if you earn some money, for example, £10,000 per year, and you, for example, agreed at the beginning that you split in 50-50 or 40-60, doesn't matter, that all this money from partnerships split in this way and going to you personally as a self-employed, to each partner. It could be, again, it could be a limited company or self-employed or just any other structure. And this, you as a self-employed, responsible for the taxation of this part of this profit. The problem with partnership, why it's not maybe not so wide today, because it's every partner have unlimited liability for the debt that partnership can incur, for the risks. For example, somebody partnership done something wrong maybe, or it's not insured, or something happened and you have a court case and you have some demands of some money or something else, and you are personally responsible for this. In my practice, I had several cases of problems with this. One of the cases was that partnerships, they own some retail shop. It's two people, and they didn't pay it correctly, they didn't register or didn't pay correctly the VAT. And after several years, I think after 5 years, the VAT, they had VAT inspection, and they said, okay, 5 years ago you didn't pay £15,000, it was approximately this amount, and they already closed, I think, that partnership at that date, but the boss partners were responsible for this debt, and it's not possible to avoid, so they personally will need to pay this debt, $15,000. In case of the limited company, if they had a limited company or limited liability partnerships, this debt would be, it might be managed more easier. You could dissolve company or do voluntary some volunteer arrangements, and it's less painful, I would say. So it was one of the reasons that it's a limited liability partnership, and in this partnership you already need to register this partnership in company's house, so it's already some procedure. You need to do the agreement, you need to have the responsible partner, and who is responsible for the submitting reports, for the submitting taxation reports. And this partnership is, again, it's a separate entity, legal structure. And it's more like it have the properties of both limited companies and the classical partnerships. The property of the limited company is that it's a limited liability for the debts, and the property of the partnership that it's taxed personally for each party, not through the company itself. And the next structure is just, it's a usual limited liability company, limited by shares. There are several limitations, limited by guarantee, limited by shares. So when you see the sign limited, it's usually limited by shares. Limited by guarantee also could be limited, but could be not limited. It's some small, very small specifics. So it's difficult to say what is better, limited liability company or limited liability partnership. And it all depends what are your personal circumstances and where, for example, why the limited liability partnerships are popular sometimes, because it's allowing the partners that are not non-residents in the UK, for example, to avoid UK taxation that might be higher than in other countries where they're residents. And there are some specifics also. It's the structure specifically made for maybe not to avoid in tax, but more flexible with the taxation of non-residents. Okay, about the company, maybe it's the, I think if you are all UK residents and you decided to do some business together, maybe it's the most simple and it could be said that it's more correct, but it's more simple and more flexible way how to do the partnership. Because you can split, you can do different types of shares, you can split different percentage, you can appoint a director, you can do a lot of different things with a limited company. And also important, it's very easy to sell this company itself. Because with a partnership, when you're trying to sell usual partnerships, it's becoming very difficult, because it's what are you selling? It's just the shares of different personal people. And when you sell in limited company, you're just selling shares. So it's more easy. It's also easier, I think, to put investment, to attract investment to limited companies, because again, you can issue shares, you can divide different classes of shares and decide how all parties participate. So this is, if you have specific question about these types, I'm not exactly the lawyer, and I don't know a lot of stuff about the I don't have a lot of experience with general partnerships and limited partnerships, but because it's older structures, I had only negative experience. But if you have any questions about the other structures, you can ask. And I can tell you what to consider before doing some movement to work together with other people.
No? We can carry on. No.
Okay. So first of all, I would go to the very end, and this is it's a very common mistakes when the several people start in business together. The less they have experience in the business and in the experience informing before it's of experience mistakes, the less chance they would ask advisor, lawyer, accountant for the advice. So they just see, okay, this is a good structure, let's do it, and we'll find out later. So So this is the, it's in my experience. The more experienced businessmen, for example, the investors or very experienced businessmen, they spent a lot of money for the advisors. And because it's a lot of specifics, and it's every mistake might be, especially if the business have prospects to be bigger, it's every small mistake could be very costly at the end. Even for the very small partnerships and companies, these mistakes usually cost much more than the money they invested in the beginning to ask for an advice. You can get even free advice, or just search the different sources, not one source, but a lot of different sources, because it's a kind of complicated stuff. Written agreement. You don't need to do the written agreement in many cases, even in limited liability companies. But it's a good practice to have some sort of shareholding agreement if you think you might have situation in the future that will have arguments how go together, how to appoint a director, how to issue new shares or something else. So, because the standard document that you're doing when you form in the company is articles of incorporation, and it's not exactly like a shareholding agreement. Okay, what to consider when you do partnerships? The first consideration should be your personal circumstances, and you need to estimate how much, for example, in the worst or in the best case scenario, this partnership could earn, and how much money you're going to extract from this partnership. And if it has a potential, for example, if you're building a house together with a partner, you invested, for example, 100K each, and okay, if you're doing a partnership, for example, you can earn 50,000 and extract it the same year. And the problem in the partnership that you will be taxed from all 25 or 50,000 the same year. And depending on your personal circumstances, you can go to the higher rate or upper higher rate, and it's not very flexible from the point of taxation. Okay, about the tax residency, I explained. So if you are not UK resident, it could be the good idea to consider different structures. So in some cases you could avoid the UK corporation tax. And the costs of all important thing about the whole stuff. It's also so I still hearing from some people some very strange things that. If you have a partnership, or if you have a even charity, or that doesn't matter, not limited company, you not need to register, think about VAT, POA, pension. No, it's not true. Even if you have a usual partnership, it's the same legal obligation about the old taxation, about the VAT and how you employ people, so it's absolutely the same. So it will not, so some people think that even self-employed, some people think, okay, I will do this. This business is a self-employed or is a partnership, because it's cheaper. It's cheaper to pay to the accountant, to the lawyer. It's easier to set up. No, it's not. It's not. It will be not cheaper. If you have some turnover, some 50 or 100,000 per year or more, the more turnover you have, the costs are absolutely the same. So it's not cheaper. It's just less flexible structure and more potential problems. Yeah, I think that's it.
And the second slide,
huh?
Yeah, you said that there is anyway you need to be